Welcome back. Now, the next report is the major event that happened this week in the National Assembly. The allegations presented against the chairman of the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission before the Senate Committee on Ethics, Privileges and Public Petition. After several days of media reports of alleged corruption at the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, it was time for the petitioner to make his case before the Senate Committee on Ethics, Privileges and Public Petition, a case of over 1 trillion naira allegedly diverted by the Anti-Graft Commission. The petitioner, George Uboh, outlined his case.
A searchlight on EFCC has shown that the commission has not only violated the provisions of its own extant law and financial regulations, but has descended into the abyss of corruption and financial crimes. The following verifiable facts are irrefutable. One, EFCC operates accounts in banks to warehouse recovered funds which do not reflect in EFCC's audited accounts. Two, EFCC doctors and manipulates bank accounts to conceal diversion of funds. Three, EFCC releases recovered funds to unidentified persons and EFCC officials. Four, EFCC moves funds from its recovery accounts to EFCC operations accounts from where it diverts same. Five, over 95% of EFCC's recoveries in foreign currencies other than those from multinational companies have been diverted. Six, EFCC trades with recovered funds through bank deposits and placements. Seven, EFCC colludes with real estate companies in order to grossly undervalue seized assets before they are sold to their cronies. Eight, EFCC has not accounted for offshore recoveries. And nine, over half of the assets seized from suspects are not reflected in EFCC exhibit records. Sir, the aggregate funds diverted by Lamode/EFCC stated below in the attached criminal charges is over 1 trillion. However, because over 95% of overseas seizures are diverted, there is urgent need to investigate and recover those funds as well.
He also alleged that the anti-graft agency admitted to under-reporting monies recovered from former governor of Bayelsa State, Diepreye Alamieyeseigha.
As at the 30th of October 2013, EFCC is still keeping back the sum of 1.6 billion naira that belongs to the Bayelsa State government. This amount is part of the 3.2 billion tucked away by EFCC in a fixed deposit account with Access Bank, CSBC. CSBC 6 here. So I approached DSP Alamieyeseigha and I showed him this evidence. And DSP said, yes, you are right. Everything they took from me were never accounted for. But who am I to say anything? Everybody already, you know, brands me as a thief. And I went to the state government. I disclosed the same to them. They said, the amount you have they sent to us is exactly what we received. I said, now you have a refund, $1.4 billion and $1.3 million. They said, what do we do? I said, give me a letter of mandate. So there's a letter from Bayelsa State to me. That is a mandate letter written to me to collect these monies. So based on the mandate, I formally wrote EFCC. Now, everything transpired in 2013. So anybody that is saying that this is a new thing is lying. Then you see EFCC's letter to me inviting me for 12 December 2013 for 19th of December to appear 19th of December 2013. I attended the meeting with Iwoha, the head of asset forfeiture. Lasted for like 5, 6, 7 minutes. Very short, brief meeting. I said, yes, we have the money. Before the beginning of 2014, you will have the money in your account. I was to receive the money, keep my percentage, send the balance to my client, Bayelsa State. 2014 came, we were playing phone tags, money never came. if all Nigerians are aware, around February, March 2014, something went viral that Bayelsa State dragged the EFCC to court. That was me. I felt if EFCC didn't want to pay the money, I had to take them to court. I took EFCC to court. The same day the news went viral, the governor of Bayelsa State came out and denied me that he did not give me mandate, that he's not suing EFCC.
The chairman of the Senate committee read out a letter from the anti-graft agency asking for another date to appear before the committee.
You are kindly invited to that. Note that the commission has since May 2014 commissioned KPGM to carry out an independent and thorough audit of SEM from the inception of the commission to date in all six geopolitical zones of the Federation where we have our offices. We shall submit the report to the National Assembly as part of our annual report and to the committee in particular in about 3 weeks when we must have finished reconciliation with the audit firm.
An official of the anti-graft agency who was present at the event, however, questioned the procedure adopted by the committee.
I really want to be enlightened with utmost respect. I don't know the procedure of the committee. I don't know. I would like to know how the propriety of hearing a petitioner in our absence when he's making his presentation, referring to documents, making oral documents, which we are not even present to address.
We are here today to listen to the petitioner, draw evidence from his presentation, and then invite you in, at a later date, and also listen to you and draw information from your presentation. Then we will bring, if there's need, we will bring both of you together.
But when the official continued with more comments, the committee took a stand.
With due respect, please, we will want you to excuse us, just like my colleagues have said. We'll have a time when we'll invite you.
The meeting came to a close a few minutes later.
The Senate committee has completed the first phase of this hearing. It says it will now sit down and decide when it will hear from the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission before taking a decision on this petition.